Hello, I'm your host Dom the Big D, and if everything went correctly, this video should be up on the first day of 2019. And in that case, Happy New Year's, everybody! I thought it would be interesting to reflect back on 2018 and see what albums seem to deserve the most attention to me. I'm not saying that the albums I'm going to mention were absolutely the best ones last year. I'm also sure I have missed plenty of records I would have liked a lot. But these are what I enjoyed listening to. So I guess let's start the list in order of release date. If any of these are incorrect, that might be because I'm living in another timeline than you. I'm also too lazy to double check. Anyway, here we go. I don't usually listen to jazz, yet I low-key enjoy it. And it's the most enjoyable to me when it's mixed with some other genre. Pure jazz just doesn't do it for me. But Mopo here have released their first album, I believe, called Mopocalypse, which sounds like a rock played with instruments usual to jazz genre, and it sounds great. Since there are no vocals and the music itself is pretty upbeat, it feels like it would make for a pretty good comedy film soundtrack. Alright, let's get into goth territory. Criminal by industrial rock band The Soft Moon to me sounds like their best album so far. I've seen a lot of people comparing them to early Nine Inch Nails, but I can't confirm how similar the sound is since I haven't listened to Nine Inch Nails all that much myself. But I can definitely say it's a pretty strong album. And it's not hard to listen to, so if you like goth rock, it's worth a shot. Well, it isn't my favorite album of theirs. Cora by Yori Klotz really deserves to be mentioned here. These dudes are probably my favorite folk band right now. They draw inspiration from many old folklore songs from many European countries and cultures, but their music, even though it is performed with acoustic medieval instruments, well, mostly, is great if you want to have a great time and dance your butt off. It's seriously very fun music to listen to. Alright, I listened to a lot of goth rock in 2018, but Vows were my favorite in the genre. I feel like Under the World wasn't as strong as The Great Sun as an album, but individual songs sound great. It just feels like more of the same after their last album. In fact, they sound so similar that one could say, hey, did you enjoy The Great Sun? Well, there's a part 2, but I just cannot dislike this duo, or trio by now since they got a drummer for live shows. But yeah, you like edgy goth industrial rock rap? You go listen to Vows. I have listened to Break and Reference earlier, and while I acknowledge that the music is really solid, it didn't capture my attention all that much. I couldn't see the same about his most recent work, Alien Pains. That was straight up amazing. I've only discovered Christian Fitness this year, and they did a great job of scratching my itch for some humorous rock. I have a soft spot for that. The lyrics are witty, the instrumentals sound good, but I can't say how the album compares to their earlier works. I haven't listened to them much. The revival of Les Butters Nord was very exciting to me. Their lineup is not the same. The album might not be as strong as the masterpieces they made all these years ago before disbanding, but hearing these people again is a big event for me. And I really hope I can get a chance to see them live before they go tits up again, because nobody seems to know about this marvelous folk band. I've made a full review of this album, so all that needed to be said about it is already said. I can only repeat myself and say that this album had a couple of killer tracks, but the rest of it wasn't all that impressive. I really like the weirdness of Sophie's music. It's hard, nasty, chaotic, but it's also clean and well executed. Of course, Death Grips' album was the most anticipated for me. I told in my review that this feels like an album that grows on you with time, but it has been half a year and it still hasn't clicked completely with me, mostly due to tracks I didn't like all that much, like Linda's in Custody or Little Richard, and the odd mixing slash mastering which sounds off-putting to me. Otherwise, this is probably one of the weirdest Death Grips albums along with Niggas on the Moon. And don't give me shit for saying the N-word, it's part of the title. I have already mentioned in this video that I don't listen to a lot of Nine Inch Nails, but damn, Bad Witch was a really great album. It could be longer though. Yeah, I know. This is a bit of an odd inclusion in this list, but I've been a fan of gorillas for a pretty long time. But after the train wreck called Humans, I lost the hope that this animated band can still make anything decent. The Now-Now kinda slipped under my radar because of that at first. It was also a bit surprising to me to see another album from them so soon after the last one. But it had some tracks I really enjoyed, like Trans or Hollywood. I'd say the Now-Now was a pretty decent recovery for gorillas. It's far from being 10 out of 10, but it's still okay-ish.
Smoking dope, short shorts, cigarette. Getting high in the morning, buying things off the internet. Sports! Sports!
Viagra Boys are one of the best discoveries I made this year. And their album Streetworms sure sounds like the best debut of 2018 to me as well. Well, they did release some singles or EPs or whatever a bit earlier, but this is their first full-length album and it kicks ass. I really like listening to this Adidas-wearing Swede. Like Auto and Punisher a lot for a lot of reasons, and one of them is that, contrary to recent trend in metal, his music is getting harder with every album, and not softer and more depressive. Beastland is probably his heaviest, noisiest, nastiest album so far. But while I do like it a lot, I am not 100% into that super noisy and distorted sound. Because it gets harder to make out individual sounds. It's like one thick heavy mesh of sound. I wouldn't complain about it too much, but one of the songs in the album was taken and remade from his previous work, Pressure Mine. And while the original version wasn't perfect, and I completely understand what the author and Punisher wanted to change, I still prefer the old version, because I think its flows give it more personality. Either way, Beastland is one of the most important industrial metal albums of 2018, in my opinion. I've made a review of this album as well, so there isn't much to say except that even though Machine Girl changed the sound a little bit in this album, it ended up being probably my favorite album of the year. Another album that I reviewed. If you haven't heard of Street Sex by now, they make super hard and nihilistic music, and you would do yourself a great service by listening to The King Mule, since it is their best work so far. You can thank me later if you end up liking them, and if you don't, I hope your ears started bleeding from listening to them.
I let it into my home. Let it.
Continuing on nihilistic ear-piercing industrial music, we've got Daughters with their new album, You Won't Get What You Want. And what do you know, it was released on the same day as The King Mule. Must have been a great day for the fans of this genre. I'll discover the Daughters right before the end of the year, and I'm not yet too familiar with their work, but this album sounds great. And if I had to describe this album using bands I've already listened to, I'd say it sounds like old school Swans, with the slow, hard songs, but injected with some noisiness and darkness of street sects. That makes for double darkness or something. It's pretty hard shit, I tell you.
By the sewer, where the rain goes down. Like this girl I once knew, cause the sewer is so low. And the
Thought Gang is definitely the most weird and bizarre album of 2018, but what else could you expect from dudes like David Lynch and Angelo Badalamenti? I'd classify this music as industrial jazz, but it's impossible to fit it into any frame really. And that's about all I've got. And if anyone releases an amazing album just before Christmas or New Year's, well, F them. I won't record this again. I'm sure I miss plenty of great music releases, so feel free to share your favorite albums of 2018 in the comment section below. Thank you for watching and see you in another video.